giant statues. It's so audacious.
Ramesses has embarked on his most ambitious building project, a vast temple on the edge of his empire.
This temple is built far afield to celebrate the king, so that he's not infringing on the territory of the god Amun.
It has taken generations of work to uncover the true scale of Ramesses' achievements here. At Abu Simbel, Ramesses was literally breaking new ground, because unlike his other monuments, this temple was not built, but cut from the rock. Instead of transporting stone to the site, they carried it away. Teams of masons took the sandstone until four great statues of their pharaoh emerged, each one almost 70 feet high. Attempt to intimidate the local Nubian population.
The Nubians were in possession of Egypt's principal source of gold, and it was extremely important that Egypt maintain control over the gold mines and the trade routes that led into Africa, sourcing ebony, ivory, slaves, and so forth.
The interior of the temple was equally ambitious. A network of chambers tunneled over 150 feet back into the cliff. And on 2 days a year, there is a dramatic demonstration of the architect's grasp of astronomy and the precision of his buildings. The sun's rays travel all the way through these chambers, hitting the inner sanctuary, the place where Ramesses' statue stands with those of three other divinities. And so Ramesses proves his point. He is not merely the greatest of the pharaohs whilst alive.
Ramesses II is one of the few kings in Egyptian history to declare himself divine before he died.
I think many in Egypt would be awestruck that a king could live to such an age, could produce what he produced. And it is quite possible that some ancient Egyptians did believe that.